not complicated to start a social enterprise in the United Kingdom. As long as people are clear about what it is they want and they've identified what it is they're trying to achieve, then I think there are legal structures available that allow it to be piloted, to be tried out without too many liabilities. As social enterprises develop in the UK, many of them become companies limited by guarantee. They're limited by guarantee. That means that the directors cannot benefit. Only the only people who can benefit are the people identified by the aims and objects of the organisation. Recently, in the last 5 years, we have a thing called a community interest company, which, as was mentioned, has some advantages, but it doesn't itself determine the legal structure. It gives a framework for social enterprises to work. But we don't have any, since the last century, we have no new laws to determine social enterprise activity. We use corporate law, we adapt corporate law in order to develop things in the UK.
U Hrvatskoj imamo temeljni okvir za pokretanje društvenih i rad društvenih poduzeća, međutim ono što nedostaje je širi poticajni podržavajući pravni okvir koji se ne odnosi naravno samo na pravne oblike, nego na sve ostale podupiruće mehanizme, dakle od propisa koje se tiču knjigovodstva i računovodstva, preko poreznih propisa, financijskih propisa, dostupnosti sredstava za pokretanje takvih poduzeća, dakle za uzimanje zajmova, kredita itd. Ulazak Republike Hrvatske u EU trebao bi dodatno potaknuti razvoj društvenog poduzetništva i kroz razvoj organizacijskih struktura i pravnih oblika, ali između ostalog iz toga što se pojavljuju zapravo prilično veliki izvori sredstava za pokretanje društveno-poduzetničkih pothvata i inicijativa, bez obzira o kojim pravnim oblicima govorili.
It originally started recycling plastic when nobody wanted to do that. It now recycles textiles, paper, tin, aluminium, plastic, not glass, everything except glass. That started out over 20 years ago as a project for people with learning disabilities to give them employment. And for many years it was a very simple project and only had a very small turnover. And now it has a turnover of about £1.25 million. And employs a number of people, about 30 odd people full time, as well as lots of volunteers and lots of trainees.